What is settled in for a great draft champions contest here. Lucky to witness it. I'm Brandon Gaughan with Charles Davis. These guys that you see on your screen, they won't be witnessing. They will be participating in what should be an excellent game. Let's get down to the field. It's time for kick. And it's the birth of a new club as we're underway in draft champions. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. To jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Time running out here on the play clock. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. This is caught inside the 15. A huge play there right off the bat. 62 yards. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Quincy Anunua that time, and that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Second down now after the incompletion. First carry for the Hall of Famer, Marcus Allen. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Marcus Allen taking it in from 11 yards out. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. From Texas A&M, Kristen Michael. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, but led to a really nice game.
Throwing now, Elway on first down. Going up top. And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Again on second and 10, it's Elway. Forced out to his left. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it, incomplete. They got pressure there and only rushing 3.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with 3 there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
On third down, Elway. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Allen that time, and now it's second down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Second and 10. He'll look to throw again. He's going to look for Allen. It's caught inside the 25. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there's going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike. He's already scored once. He definitely had his eyes wide open trying to get in there a second time, but I thought that was a really nice play defensively to deny him.
Yeah, it was. As you said, keeping him away from his second first quarter touchdown there. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
The line of scrimmage is the two here on third and goal. They come out here in the eye. Third and goal now. The defense looking to hold serve again. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Marcus Allen with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. Well, he told us he was going to hit the end zone a couple times in this game. I just don't know that he envisioned doing it in the first quarter.
He probably did. I'm not sure we did, right? Because all the great ones, that's what they do. They dream about it, right? They think about it. They envision it. They think it's going to happen and almost will themselves into it. I just look at what he's done so far and just wonder, what's left to come? Let's sit back and enjoy this one.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Buying time to his left. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Boy, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? That's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity-bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
Hurry up, here we go. Blocker.
So here we go. Elway on fourth down. He's going to air one out. And this pass is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled down.
And it's caught. Touchdown. Allen Robinson from 10 yards out. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script, didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. Three drives, three touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good as, that is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one taken from the 7. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Bryce Butler, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Second and 10, Elway again. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. That one good for 16 and the drive will continue.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it's... away and incomplete. And on second and 10 now.
Here we go now.
Second and 10, Elway. It's caught. It's Dennis Pittle. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
The 21 yards there as they convert on third. And on display right there, the arm that made John Elway a lot of money.
And that's going to leave a mark, because when he throws it with that much force, one of the best arms the game has ever seen, one of the strongest ones, it does leave a mark. They actually called it the Elway Cross, because you could see the imprint on a player after he caught one of those bullet passes.
Detroit! Detroit!
Elway looking to pass again. That is caught, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia! Kamar Aiken, 27 yards, and the Eagles get a score closer. And he puts it through. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
Man, it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Going deep here for Allen. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, 3rd down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. And they'll send the tight end in motion left. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples.
But into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Third down and 3. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. And the play clock's running down. They'll drop the throw. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. It's a big play there on 3rd down. 61 yards. And the 2-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
Play clock winding down. Brief break in the action here. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On the toss, here's Allen. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Keep it on the ground. Allen again. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Boy, you'd hate to squander this great field position. Here's 3rd and goal. They'll come out in the pistol.
Go.
third down and goal from the 8. Here's Allen. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Marcus Allen on his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And it's up and good. Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position, and he just gets taken out.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one taken from the 7. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's 2nd and 10. Elway to throw on 2nd. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Elway now looking to throw on 3rd. And it's brought in by Pitta. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. So the offense has it 1st and 10. On 1st, they'll throw with Elway. And his throw here is incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
2nd and 10, Elway again. The throw to the left side, caught by Coleman. And they'll get 9 there, as that sets them up better for 3rd down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On 3rd and 1, it's Elway. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and 1 yard. He sets to fire deep. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Bryce Butler, 57 yards. And the Eagles make some inroads here on that deficit.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Try and start this drive in the air. He's going to look for... He's got a man complete. A big play there just before halftime. 74 yards.
So what's the old expression that quarterbacks like to use when they decide to throw the football? I'm looking for either a touchdown or a check down. And he took the check down on that play, and it worked almost to perfection.
They'll try and run it in with Burton. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
smash mouth football right here on first down.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll run. This is Allen. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken at his four. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Final play of the half, it's Elway. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. And hello, I guess Larry's halftime show has buttoned through. And we are moving on and ready to go for the third quarter. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
going to do that?
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Second and 10, Elway. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. But in tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just one.
Is that what they say?
There it is. You know, put a little sand down on the stage.
I'll take your word for it, my man. The intended target was Corey Coleman, and it's fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. So here we go. Elway on fourth down. Trying to lay one up deep. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They'll have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They'll run with Allen, and he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They stay on the ground with Allen. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one. Maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
Now Allen. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Yeah, let me pump out my chest a little bit. Even though I'm not rooting for either team, that was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears try to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it here. It's caught. It's Dennis Pitta. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Now a carry for Allen. A gain of three, second down.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Time running out here on the play clock, and they'll run it here. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Again, we'll see the pistol here. The play clock's running down. Now a handoff here to his running back. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
Now that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let them get anywhere near it.
Sean Payton's made the decision here. They will go for it on fourth. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Play clock winding down. The play clock getting low, so Sean Payton says, let's take a timeout. And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. We'll be back. The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and two. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And he motions the wide receiver.
200 yet. Eagle. Back. That kick. 200 yet. Lumber. That kick. 200 yet.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Robinson with a big catch. And he will take it in for the touchdown. Allen Robinson, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. And Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back now here on EA Sports. First and 10, Elway. He's going to let this one go deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Again on second and 10, it's Elway. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Kyle Williams in there to get him for what will be a loss of 13 yards. And the O-line will have to do a better job protecting here on third down after that sack. So the D-line's going to spread out. Now Elway on third and long. Surveying the field. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact.